My name is Steve Wilson. I'm the project director for Dogger Bank Wind Farm. I work with SSE Renewables and I'm responsible for a safe on-time delivery of the three phases of the world's largest offshore wind farm. Dogger Bank's size and scale has allowed it to innovate quite significantly within offshore wind. So it's allowed us to introduce a number of new technologies into the project, such as the 13 and 14 megawatt Haley 8X turbines and our HVDC transmission system. It's also allowed us to work with the supply chain to invest in additional installation vessels that will be used in the project. So examples of that are the Alpha Lift, which OHT are currently constructing, which will undertake the foundation installation, and also the Voltaire, which Jan De Nul are building as well, which will undertake the installation of the Haley 8X turbines. So really, whilst those present benefits to Dogger Bank, they will also significantly benefit the wider offshore renewable industry in the future. The HVDC technology that will be used for the first time in the UK on Dogger Bank is being developed such that it optimising the design and application of the technology. So it's significantly reducing the size and weight of platforms and subsequently significantly lowering the cost base of the offshore transmission system. So for further offshore wind farms that will be developed in the future, Dogger Bank is enabling those projects to find a route to market through its innovation in HVDC. With regard to the turbine technology, obviously the larger turbines that again will be deployed for the first time on Dogger Bank will shape the future of the industry, again by further lowering the cost of offshore wind. I think with the selection of GE, it will broaden the market for turbine supply, which will also benefit other developers. And then the vessel technology that's being developed for Dogger Bank, again, that will be used extensively in other offshore wind projects, and again, will aid significantly in improving the efficiency and also reducing the cost of development of these large-scale offshore wind farms. Dogger Bank's scale is allowing development of supply chain in the UK through GE's blade facility. GE have been able to make that investment with LM in a facility in Teesside as a consequence of the Dogger Bank order and the size of that project. And that, again, provides facilities that will be used by other developers in the future and should lower the cost base for UK projects. And we're working very closely with other Tier 1 and Tier 2 suppliers to look to try to introduce additional facilities within the UK that can get a seed order from Dogger Bank. And we expect to be able to make announcements on those in the near future. And that will, again, provide further options for UK projects and to increase the UK content that they have, but also to use state-of-the-art facilities that are being developed as a consequence of Dogger Bank, our investment in the global supply chain. Again, Dogger Bank is a project that will provide power for over 6 million homes when it's complete. So it's going to be providing up to 5% of the UK's current electricity demand. So that's going to make a significant contribution to driving the UK towards net zero by 2050. And it's also going to make a significant contribution to the 40 gigawatt target for offshore wind that's deployed by 2030.
Over 200 jobs will be created at the operations and maintenance base, which will be a mix of roles from Equinor and GE. Equinor is leading on the operations phase. This is already providing opportunities in Northeast England, with the first two employees employed from the region. And an additional 130 jobs will be created by North Star, the service offshore vessel provider. So these are long-term jobs in the region. But the project is also the anchor project for GE's investment on Teesside, and we're really, really happy and proud that this project has enabled that investment, which will create over 2,250 new direct and indirect jobs. In total, almost 3,000 jobs have now been announced associated with the project, and we've been working with all types of suppliers, including a local architect that's designed our base, which will be located at the Port of Tyne, and it's sustainably designed, very nice new facility, and a really important part of attracting talent to offshore wind in the region. We work very closely with Energy Coast. Energy Coast is the North East Offshore Wind Cluster and Dogger Bank JV, so Equinor with our partners SSE and E&I, members through the Dogger Bank project. From this, we're able to support the different initiatives around skills development, innovation and supply chain that have been delivered by Energy Coast. We are obviously the home of the Offshore Renewable Energy Catapult Training Facilities in Blyth as well. And this is where GE's blade for Dogger Bank is being tested. We're also establishing a great relationship with the Port of Tyne, where the new operations and maintenance base will be. And this will contribute to the Green Energy Park at the Port of Tyne, where we have a lot of matching values around sustainability and environment. And outside of the region, we're also working with other industry bodies like RenewableUK, who play a key role in promoting the sector and helping to deliver the work of the Offshore Wind Industry Council. So the Dogger Bank team is really excited about the community fund, which will invest £1 million during the construction phase of the project. And this investment will be in STEM education and accreditation. And we're working with the local authorities in the East Riding of Yorkshire and South Tyneside, and in the future with Redcar and Cleveland as well, to develop a plan which meets the needs of the local area and pupils. So in South Tyneside, for example, this will focus on the transition from primary school to secondary school, as well as supporting local career services and promoting more young females into STEM education. And we'll also be supporting local projects with grants up to £500 from the Operators Fund, as well as planning 50 scholarships for students living in these areas, which will support further education through £5,000 towards student fees. So this is a really, really important part of how we give back to the local communities and the coastal communities that really need this investment.